Namaste. Today I'm going to speak about the solar eclipse that's happening on June 21st, 2020. A lot has been spoken about this solar eclipse on YouTube videos, on social media, in the on various blogs, on in the newspaper and stuff like that. Almost everyone has said that it's going to be very negative, and they have linked it to the coronavirus. So I'm going to share in this video if it is really negative, and if at all it's negative, for who is it negative. What I will also do is I'm going to give you certain remedies that you can follow. The solar eclipse is going to start at 9:15 a.m. Indian Standard Time. It's going to peak at around 12:10 p.m. and it's going to end at 3:04 p.m. IST. So roughly the solar eclipse is for about 6 hours. For those who are doing intense spiritual sadhana, this is one of the most precious times that you would ever get. Particularly the time between 10:17 a.m. to 2:02 p.m. is highly recommended for any types of spiritual sadhana. It could be the japam that you would be doing, it could be the homa or havana that you would be performing, it could be the vrata that you would want to observe, or any of those things. So let's look at what actually happens during the solar eclipse. What we all know is that the moon comes between the sun and the earth. But in reality, there's a little more to that than just the moon coming in. Astrologically speaking, whenever there's an eclipse that happens, it could be lunar eclipse or solar eclipse, there's a play of Rahu. Now Rahu is a very mischievous planet. It's a krura graha, very evil in nature. In the current eclipse that we're talking about, that is June 21st, 2020 eclipse that we're talking about, this eclipse happens in the sign of Mithuna. Now during the eclipse, there are four planets that you can see in Mithuna. There is Sun, Moon, Mercury, and there is Rahu. Now Rahu in Mithuna is exalted. That essentially means he's highly auspicious. He's shining with exuberance. So while he is going to eclipse the Sun as a part of his Dharma, there is very less chances that he will do anything evil or negative. In fact, in Mithuna, Rahu becomes a Shubhagraha. So, wrongly attributing the solar eclipse to this current solar eclipse to do a lot of evils is incorrect. However, there's another important aspect that we should consider. Mars is giving a fourth aspect to Mithuna. Now who is Mars? Mars is usually referred to as the commander-in-chief. So he is the one who always likes to be ready for fighting. He is extremely competitive in nature. He likes to attack. His fourth aspect on the sun, on the moon, these are the two kingly planets, king and the queen, on Mercury, prince, and Rahu essentially means that there is going to be some sort of a conflict within the government at an external level. So the relationship of the government with its neighboring countries might be a little difficult, might be under stress. But this fourth aspect of Mars, though throws up some challenges, it does not mean that we will be able to overcome the challenge. We will be able to overcome the challenges. Now, having understood how it's going to affect us, let's go into individual horoscopes. Now, what happens during an eclipse is there's a sudden difference of heat because the moon shields the sun, and there's a sudden difference of heat. Now because of this, there's a change in the pressure gradient which affects the ozone layer. Now we all know that the ozone layer blocks harmful radiation from entering the earth. But because there's a change in the ozone pressure, because there's a depression that is created, certain harmful radiations enter the earth at this point of time, which is not good for the marine life, for the animals, for the birds, and even for human beings. So it is always advisable that we stay indoors and don't get exposed to direct sunlight. Now, what do you need to do during eclipse? I'll give two points each for what has to be done before the eclipse, during the eclipse, and after the eclipse. First, let me begin by saying what we need to do during the eclipse. Before the eclipse. Now, before the eclipse, ensure that you finish all your food at least 1 hour before the eclipse starts. Now, what time does the eclipse start? It starts at 9:15 a.m. So we need to finish our meals at least 1 hour before. For those people who have medical issues, health issues, make sure at least you do it before at least the eclipse starts, if not 1 hour. Second thing you need to do is to make sure that you take a lot of darba grass and place it in the water vessels, on the food vessels, on important items that you have in your cupboards, etc. During the eclipse, as I told you, it's very good to undertake spiritual sadhana. So if you have been initiated into a mantra japam, do that. If you have not been initiated into a mantra japam, here are two things you can do. First, recite a Ganapati mantra. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. This recite it for 8 times. Followed by any one of the 2 mantras that I am going to give. The first mantra is Om Namo Narayanaya. The second mantra is Om Namah Shivaya. Both these can be recited as many times as possible. And you need to do it in multiples of 108. The Om Namah Shivaya needs to be recited using a Rudraksha Mala and Om Namo Narayanaya using a Tulsi Mala. Another thing that you need to do during the eclipse is to observe what we call as the waterless fast. That means you don't eat anything, you don't even consume water. If that is not possible, try to take a little bit of water, but the best is to not have anything. Post eclipse, what you need to do is immediately not undertake any activity, but to go to your respective washrooms and have a cold water bath if possible. Otherwise, a regular warm water is also fine. But make sure the water that you use is purified by the darba grass. So this is the one this is the vessel in which you would have placed the darba grass. Now, coming to individuals, this eclipse will cause some sort of a problem to three kinds of people. One is the pregnant woman or new mothers, especially those who are lactating. The second one are those who are unmarried. It could be both male or female, boy or girl, unmarried people. The third one is to older men, especially those who have these smaller diseases like diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol, etc. Now, specifically, those people with Mesha Rashi need to be extra cautious. They will have a very bad influence of the eclipse. Those people with Kumbha, Tula, Mithuna and Kataka, they will have certain bad effects, but not as bad as that of Mesha Rashi. So it will be bad, but it will not be as bad as those who have Mesha Rashi. The intensity will be much slower. So you also have to be careful. Vrishabha Rashi people, it will be good for them. While the rest, it will be average. It will neither be good nor bad. What I would recommend each one of you to do is to make sure you take care of your health if you are taking some medicines, make sure that you don't skip any medicines. Do take the food at the right time and do the right type of physical activity. This virus that we have, the coronavirus, as I've told in my previous videos, the cure is going to come only after Jupiter enters Sagittarius, that is in own house. There are a lot of videos that link the current solar eclipse with coronavirus. It is only partially correct, it is not completely correct. I hope this video was informative and educative. Feel free to comment on your thoughts and also let me know if you want me to speak on certain specific topics. Till next time, Namaste.